Baldessari, you know, John Baldessari did similar things, the similar pictures. Were you thinking about them, or
nothing to do with John Baldessari?
How about this one over there? It's the Big Moon is. Which is the remake of
the difference is I am a woman.
Yeah.
I am a woman. I do have a vagina. This is me, you know, and men can interpret this thing stuff as much as they like, but they haven't got it.
Mm-hmm.
And now what's really interesting for women now is women can be their own muses, their own models.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we don't have to be the muse or the model anymore. We have ourselves. We're one step ahead of every male painter that has ever happened, you know, that has ever, you know. Picasso, imagine if he'd been a woman, how much more successful he could have been being able to paint himself. Eve Klein being able to roll himself across that canvas, you know. All the time they had to ask people.
I was going
to
ask you a question about yourself. I sound really sycophantic, but I've been a fan of your art for a long time, and I'm a fan of it because you put so much of yourself into it, and I think that's really honest. And so, do you get people criticising you a lot?
Last night I did a talk at the Foundling. I'm really tired this week. I did a talk at the Foundling Museum last night, and I thought it was subject matter was very difficult and very hardcore, because it's a Foundling Museum. It's about orphans. It's about neglected children. It's about all these kind of issues. So it wasn't going to be like the nicest, funniest talk in the whole world. And I was kind of quite diverse about all different subjects. I tried to lighten it up occasionally. And then this woman at the end, she came up to me, she said, I had this woman who sat next to me, just kept tutting the whole time and just said, all she keeps going on about is herself, talking about me. It's my bloody talk, you know. It's my work, it's my talk. They paid her tickets to listen to me. What am I supposed to go on about? So, geography or something, I don't know. History, I'm not sure. But I do get criticised about the indulgence of myself in my work. But then so does Louise Bourgeois,
yeah.
so did Frida Kahlo, so did most women who were strong women, who had a definite focus, a subject which they dealt with. They always get knocked to pieces because
But doesn't it make it harder because it's your work and it's about yourself, so you're being doubly criticised?
No, because what I can do is, this is a gallery, and this is a picture in a gallery, this is artwork,
yeah.
This is me. Two really separate things,
yeah.
And this is what a lot of critics kind of kept making a mess of in the 90s. They didn't understand that I was an artist. They kept blurring it themselves. I didn't. I saw the definition of the difference. They couldn't see it. So I think as long as you understand that subject that you're dealing with is within an art context, then you're quite safe. I'd want to start going to a therapist immediately.
It was criticized again, like about being calligraphic, perhaps. And I thought, is that Tracey Emin trying to escape, you know, from the self and trying to.
Two things, really. First of all, in Venice, I've forgotten how many, I think it's 1 million, I took the numbers, 1,500,000 visitors, okay, go to Venice. Majority of those people don't speak English. Okay, I first of all wanted to do a show that was much more universal. I wanted to do a show that was about art, and I wanted to do a show in Venice which was about me going forward, not me going backwards. And that's what I did. And the criticism I got about Venice, I can assure you, a lot of it wasn't about my work.
Did
you
enjoy it, actually?
No, I didn't enjoy the criticism. No, of course I didn't. I cried on my opening day because it was so vicious and so nasty. It was to do with my lifestyle, to do with the parties that I have, to do with the way that I dress, to do with the fact that a certain amount of people didn't want me to get Venice or do it.
You know, the things that I knew about, you know,
you can't go to Venice and do a retrospective. That's not what it's about.
Yeah.
Venice is about here and now and what you're doing. And when you're asked in Venice, that's the only time in your life you're ever going to be asked. If you say no, you won't get asked again. So it doesn't matter what's happening to you during your personal life, what's happening in your studio, doesn't matter what's happening work-wise, you say yes, and you do it, and you do it as best as you possibly can. And the other thing about Venice is most artists are given a year and a half's warning. I was given 8 months, and out of that 8 months, for two of those months, I had complete commitments that I couldn't get out of. So in a way, Venice was like bad timing for me, but it was the only timing for me, and we had the best parties Venice has ever seen. And anyone that was there with me would absolutely agree on that. It was fantastic. And that's like a moment of a lifetime. You know, when I'm old, I look back at that, or every time I go to Venice, I remember this like amazing time I had. It was like getting married 1,000 times over,
yeah,
with a bigger dress, with a bigger crowd, with a bigger party, with a bigger night, the next night, the next night, the next night. So lots of things about it were brilliant. But I have always said I'm probably the only artist that would do Venice twice, because I think I'll probably do it when I'm old. If Venice is still there, though. any other questions?
Are there any more questions?
Is that the safest place to get money?
Probably, yeah.
Or foreign.
Brilliant. Cool. But I was so cold when I got here.
Much to Anna Catherina, to Tracey, to Sophie, and to Alex.
Sophie,
and thank
yeah.
you to all for squeezing into these very tight spaces. Please make sure you look at the rest of the show and make your own connections between things as you go around as well. Thank you.
Thank you.